Let us now go to the first example of an animal-human interface. We wanted to know how much the human seroprevalence of brucellosis depended on livestock in Kyrgyzstan. In Kyrgyzstan, we keep sheep, goat, and cattle. But at the outset, we don't know which is the most dangerous animal for human brucellosis. So we designed a study where we sampled simultaneously sheep and goat, cattle, and humans, possibly in the same household or at least in the same village. And here is the summary of the data collection. You see that we collected 1,800 cattle sera, 2,000 sheep, 1,200 goats, and 1,700 humans. We did Ross Bengal tests, but we did also ELISA. At the end, and fluorescence polarization. At the end, we regressed human seroprevalence against animal seroprevalence. We could actually use the same ELISA, but we used the anti-human conjugate for the human data. And here you see the geographical area in Kyrgyzstan. This is a nationally representative study. And you see here in the regression that sheep are the most related to human seroprevalence. The relationship to cattle was even negative, and the relationship to goat was not statistically significant. We could confirm this animal source of a human illness further by molecularly characterizing bacteria that we isolated from sheep and cattle. We did not find any abortion in goat. So this is a one health study because in one study we could find a zoonotic relationship that we could never find if we only study humans or only animals. Secondly, we saved money because we could share the transport and also the laboratory. In this way, we created an added value of knowledge and a financial incremental benefit. This whole study costed less than $100,000.